Tip thought this strange army bore no weapons whatsoever, but in this he was wrong, for each girl had stuck through the knot of her back hair two long glittering knitting needles. General Ginger immediately mounted the stump of a tree and addressed her army. "Friends, fellow citizens and girls," she said, "we are about to begin our great revolt against the men of Oz. We march to conquer the Emerald City, to dethrone the Scarecrow King, to acquire thousands of gorgeous gems, to rifle the royal treasury, and to obtain power over our former oppressors." "Hurrah!" said those who had listened, but Tip thought most of the army was too much engaged in chattering to pay attention to the words of the general. The command to march was now given, and the girls formed themselves into four bands, or companies, and set off with eager strides toward the Emerald City. The boy followed after them, carrying several baskets and wraps and packages which various members of the Army of Revolt had placed in his care. It was not long before they came to the green granite walls of the city and halted before the gateway. The guardian of the gate at once came out and looked at them curiously, as if a circus had come to town. He carried a bunch of keys swung round his neck by a golden chain. His hands were thrust carelessly into his pockets, and he seemed to have no idea at all that the city was threatened by rebels. Speaking pleasantly to the girls, he said, "Good morning, my dears. What can I do for you?" "Surrender instantly," shouted General Ginger, standing before him and frowning as terribly as her pretty face would allow her to.